Welcome back. Another type of microwave diodes is barrier diode. Barrier diode is the abbreviation of barrier injection transient time diode. Barrier injection transient time. Barrier BAR. Injection I. Transient time TT. And this also can be called plasma avalanche trigger transient. Plasma avalanche trigger transient. So it can also be abbreviated as barrier diode. Barrier diode has a similar construction to BNP junction transistor. So barrier diode has structure similar to a junction transistor without a base connection. So effectively the base is not connected, or we have not a terminal to the base. Barrier diode, similar to the input diode in the fact that it depends on the transient time. So both barrier diode and input diodes depends on the transient time of the carriers inside the diode. And according to the transient time, we can convert this diode into a negative differential resistance device. And if we use, or if we convert it into negative differential resistance device, we can use it as an oscillator or as amplifier. The main difference between barrier injection transient time and input diode is that in barrier injection transient time, there is no avalanche breakdown. And effectively, the avalanche breakdown is a noisy process. So the main advantage of the barrier diode compared with the input diode is less noisier than the input diode. So we say that the barrier diode is very similar in many aspects to the input diode, but the main difference is that the barrier diode uses thermionic emission rather than avalanche multiplication. And as I said, this will introduce less noise. So one of the advantages of using barrier diode is that the process is far less noisy, as a result that the barrier diode does not suffer from the same noise level from the input diode due to the avalanche breakdown. The construction of the barrier diode, as we see here, is B plus N junction, and this N junction is followed by a depletion region, a long depletion region. Effectively, this long depletion region is the transient time region, and this connects to the V electrode. From the point of view of forward and reverse, according to this connection, we can say that this junction is forward biased because B is connected to the positive and N is connected to the negative side. On the other hand, this NB junction is in inverse or reverse biased. Actually, I'm not working on the avalanche breakdown between this NB, but this forward biased diode will introduce some carrier here, and this carrier will not move through the depletion region until the potential or the electric field is greater than a specific value, such that it will be moving in the opposite to this NB junction without introducing breakdown in the depletion region, because the depletion region, it doesn't include carriers. That's why we say that it is a plasma avalanche trigger. Effectively, here the free carriers moving in the depletion region is not avalanche breakdown, it is plasma electrons. So, and it is mainly due to the barrier injection. We are talking about the barrier of this depletion region of moving this electron here. It has the advantage of greater than it has the advantage of greater level efficiency compared with the input microwave diodes. Typically, DC to RF signal conversion efficiency of varied diodes in the region from 20 to 60%, which is particularly higher than the input diode. As I said, the varied diode consists of two back-to-back diodes. We have BN here and NB here. When the potential is applied across the device, most the potential drop across the reverse bias diode. So the electric field or the potential is mainly in the region of the reverse bias diode, and effectively it is mainly in the depletion region. The device has an area often referred to as the emitter base. This emitter base and this is a collector. Emitter base, intermediate or drift area, and the collector. This emitter, this is the base, this is the intermediate or drift area, and this is the collector. Now, if the voltage is increased until the edges of the depletion region meet, this condition is known as the bunch through occurs. In this case, if I have increased the potential here, what happens? The depletion region due to the reverse bias will increase here. If the depletion region has increased until it reached to the depletion region of the forward biased BN junction, then the holes going from the B plus will go through the depletion region and the electrons will move towards the positive here. So if the voltage is then increased until the edges of the depletion region, the end of this depletion region and the depletion region here meet, then the condition is known as the bunch through. In the bunch through, the current will go through this diode. Before the bunch through, there is no current moving through this diode. So, in terms of the operation of the device, the depletion or the drift region need to be completely free of any carrier. And this means that the bunch through occurs to the base emitter, this base emitter region, without there being avalanche breakdown. I don't have any avalanche breakdown here because the base emitter are forward biased and the depletion region here is connected to the depletion region here as a bunch through without introducing any avalanche breakdown. So without being avalanche breakdown of the base collector junction. Close to the bunch through voltage, if I have applied a small AC signal like this, so at the peak of the AC signal, the bunch through of the depletion region or the connection of the bunch through of the connection of the depletion region will introduce carrier concentration nearly at the peak of the AC signal. So, in this case, unlike the input diode, the peak concentration of the carrier will occur at the peak of the AC signal. And this peak concentration will be drift through the drift region with the drift velocity, and it will be collected at the collector. So, we have some time delay between the carrier concentration and collecting the current, and according to the time delay, we can know that the current at the collector will have the shape of this function. Now, if you look at the phase of the applied AC voltage and the phase of the collected current, we can know that some of the collected current it would be positive when the applied AC voltage is positive. So the differential resistance at this time period, it would be positive. However, at the remaining part, the current it would be positive while the applied AC voltage is negative. So the differential resistance or the equivalent AC resistance in this part, it would be negative resistance. Effectively, the region of the negative resistance is greater than the region of the positive resistance. So the average dynamic resistance, it would be mainly negative resistance. However, this positive resistance will introduce some power dissipation, which will introduce some heat in the barrier diode in this case. So we say that the bunch through voltage, V bunch, are different for two directions. After the charge is injected, it travels to the substrate with saturation velocity in the drift region. As seen from the diagram, it can be seen that the injection current, is in phase with the RF voltage or RF voltage form in some region. This results in non-ideal current waveform situation, which follow positive resistance region, and therefore will introduce some losses in the barrier diode, which is not occurred in the input diode. So we have some losses in the barrier diode, and this loss will, as I said, will be dissipated as a heat in the barrier diode. The remaining part of the current, it would be negative. The terminal current pulse width is determined by the transient time, which is the length of the drift region over the saturation velocity. This constitutes around 3/4. This negative region or negative resistance is nearly 3/4 of the complete cycle. So effectively, nearly 3/4 of the current is negative or correspond to negative resistance, and 1/4 correspond to positive resistance. In general, the barrier diode has lower power capability than the input diode because of the loss mechanism in the barrier diode. But it has the advantage of lower AM noise or amplitude modulation noise. The operation of barrier diode is normally limited around 25 GHz for silicon and 90 GHz for gallium arsenide. So effectively, the barrier diode has limited frequency, much lower than the input diode. Barrier diodes are also useful as a detector and mixer application from the point of view of the non-linearity of the barrier diode, similar to the input diode. In view of the physical restraints of the barrier diode, the power capability decreases approximately as the square of the frequency, because increasing the frequency means that the drift region should be decreased, and if the drift region is decreased, the applied voltage should be decreased. So the power or the power capability is decreased with the square of the frequency, because higher frequency requires smaller separation between the electrodes, and this in turn limits the voltage that can be used. Also, the efficiency falls away by increasing the frequency. If I increase the frequency, I reduce the drift region. So if I reduce the drift region, the efficiency or the positive part of the current would be greater, and in this case the average negative resistance, it would be less. So the total efficiency of the system will decrease by increasing the frequency. So all the efficiency falls away with increasing the frequency. For low frequency operation, it may be around 5% or more. This is briefly what is meant by barrier diode, and what is the relation between barrier diode and input diode, and what is the advantage of barrier diode compared to the input diode, and what is the advantage of input diode compared to the barrier diode. In the following video, we are going to discuss another completely different diode, is the tunnel diode, which is another important microwave diode.